Why a ship floats and a screw of this size sinks in the water? Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Captain Zahid. Your answer to the question may be very, very simple. Buoyancy or upthrust? While the answer is correct, there are more details to it than you might think. A screw is very small. In fact, tiny in comparison to the size of a ship. A ship weighs thousands of tons. For example, the weight of this ship, our ship, it is close to 25,000 tons when she is empty. And now when she is loaded, her weight is almost 175,000 tons. And yet, she is sailing across the oceans as if everything is just nice and fine and nothing significant is going on. Compare that weight to this small screw. Its weight is hardly a few grams, let alone a kilogram. Being so light and almost weightless, throw this screw in the water and I can promise you that it will sink in the blink of an eye. Buoyancy or upthrust of water, it's always there. And it acts upon every weight that is either floating, submerged, or even partially submerged in the water. The weight of the object pushes the object down in the water and the buoyancy tries to push it out. It's like a tug of war that is going on between weight of an object and the buoyancy of water once that object is submerged or immersed in the water. The question that arises is, this buoyancy is acting equally on a ship and on this small screw. And yet, the ship keeps floating while the screw would still sink. So definitely there is something more to the question than just buoyancy of water. That is where another thing comes in, and that's called density. Density of anything is defined as the weight per unit volume, or in normal English, the weight in kilograms of an object that can fit inside a meter cube of volume. That's called density. Just like any other object in the world, seawater has its own density, ranging anywhere from 1001 to 1025 kilograms per meter cube. Freshwater, on the other hand, has a density of about 1000 kilograms per meter cube. If you immerse anything that has lesser density in this water, it will float on its top. If the density of the object that is immersed is higher in comparison to the density of water in which it is being immersed, the object will sink and submerge. The classical example is when you put some oil and honey in the same water. Put some oil in the water and it will keep on floating on the top. Put some honey in the same water and the honey would sink. Density. You might be asking yourself then, why does human beings sink in the water? And yes, your question is right. Human beings have an average density of 985 kilograms per meter cube. That is much, much lesser than the density of fresh water. Technically, human beings should always be able to float. They should not be drowning in the water. At all. That's absolutely correct. And yes, if you are a swimmer and you know how to swim, you'd also be confident enough to let your body float. And human beings, if they are not wearing the type of the clothes that would absorb a lot of water, by design, would in fact never drown in the water if they don't try hard to swim or float. If they trust their density and let their body float, they will float. But now comes a more complex question. Steel, that is mostly used on ships, is far, far heavier and dense than both the freshwater and the seawater. Yet, once it's given the shape of a ship, it starts floating. How is this achieved without lowering the density of steel and even after loading thousands of tons on top? The answer lies in its clever design that makes it possible. To understand this, let's consider a log of a wood. It floats on the top of water, right? But if you see closely, very closely, these logs are partially submerged. Some portion of these logs is out of the water, while the other portion is still inside the water. Slowly, people understood one thing, that is, if by any means they make the log hollow, some of the submerged portion of this log will come out of the water. And you can fill up the hollowed portion with practically anything as long as it doesn't submerge the whole wooden log and drown it in the sea. Here, the density of wood didn't change at all, but by making a log hollow, we were able to enable this log to actually carry something for us and yet float. What we did here is we changed the weight of the log by making it hollow. That's all we did. Using the same principle, people were able to carve out bigger boats with wooden hull, enabling them to carry not just goods, but people and equipment as well. Density wasn't changed here, but giving them an elongated shape with curved shell gives a simulation of lesser density that in turn enables a boat to float. Using the exact same principle, engineers were able to figure out a way that even if a heavier steel hull was carved out, as long as this hull was long enough and high enough, even after partially submerged in the water, it will float. If you have a closer look at the steel-made ships, their sump portion is always underwater. We measure this portion in meters and centimeters, and we call it draft of a ship. This underwater portion of a ship increases when the cargo is loaded and decreases when the ship is empty. But a certain portion of a ship is always above water, whether loaded or not. Hence, using a clever design and by using the dense steel-made plates to build stronger ships, we are now able to take advantage of water's upthrust and hence enable a ship to float. Trust me, if you design this crew clever enough, it will float too. But that's not how the design and innovation works. To make floatable screws, we first have to have a real need and then some proper usage of the floating screws in order to spend our resources and money to design the floating screws. Until then, any screws thrown in the water will keep on sinking and any vessel that is thrown on water will keep on floating. I seriously hope that I was able to convey some sort of information to you people in this video. If you have gained any knowledge in this video or if this video has helped you in any way, then consider giving this video a like, share, and consider subscribing to my channel. With tons of love to my digital family and to be digital family, this is me, Zahid Nisar. You are watching Captain Zahid, and until the next video, bye.